and a glass of champagne.
I'd always listened a lot to Billie Holiday. I'm one of the really favourite artists that I've had to listen to through the years. And I guess it was probably her version which stands out in my memory, although there are lots of other versions of the song. It's one of those classics, standards that's covered by a lot of people. I thought I'd do it in a kind of slightly different way. I also like Al Green, so I thought I'd do it in this kind of Al Green, like Memphis sort of groove. And I thought, oh well, they were two of my favourite people to listen to if I was on the road and in my hotel room or something. I listened to some Al Green, some Billie Holiday. And this is what people nowadays are called chill out music.
With a smile that makes my temperature rise like a summer with a thousand Julys. You intoxicate my soul with your eyes.
I remember the bits of the video that we did it with Carrie Ann, who was the cover girl from the first Roxy Music album. And I thought that would be interesting to do. She kept like appearing and disappearing like a mirage in this video, which was done in my house where I was living in London at my Holland Park. Well, that was one of the nice things about it, is that you felt you were introducing material from a different era to a newer audience. So that just started off a whole parallel career of me doing what singers used to do in the 50s, 60s and earlier, of just kind of interpreting songs. Elvis was a song interpreter rather than a writer, and for Sinatra, Crosby, all the big singers, really prior to Dylan and the Beatles, they turn it all around and encourage people to write for themselves, I think. So this was a kind of slightly retro notion of saying, oh well, hang on, as a singer and as a song arranger stroke producer, it would be nice to just take a song and try and transform it and do something dead interesting with it, hopefully. I guess there's some fans of early Roxy who might have been totally horrified. And they said, oh, what's he doing that for? But I thought, well, art can be fun as well as serious. If you only call it art, but let's call it art, say. And so Picasso would do, say, some pictures which are full of meaning and great beauty and very soulful. And he'd also do kind of jokey bits of pottery or ceramic work as well, which was kind of on a much lighter scale. And I think it's quite nice to do it, to be try and be light as well as heavy. And I was writing heavier stuff myself, so I was thinking, let's do some lighter, more kind of buoyant material as well, which is written by other people, and try and do something inventive with it.